Get into it. Sound effect is negative 25. Title audio is like negative 25, but all of the sound effects are like negative 15. Oh, that's right, I forgot you made the Uber ASF for that too. Some people do. Okay, so far I think both the intro sound effect and friends can be a little bit louder potentially. Because the sound effects are a little bit louder than the music, which I like it being a little bit louder than the music, but the gap is a little strong right now. Sorry, I'm gonna need to be listening to this pretty intently tonight.
So you didn't tell me that?
I did say I was gonna be doing audio leveling stuff tonight.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, so it looks like overworld
like
is at like negative 15. So this is probably about where I want basically all of the audio to be right now. Because this would basically be in line with the sound effects. I'll say this one is... It's peaking at negative 15, but it's sounding more like it's at negative 20 overall, so we'll say negative 20 and just plan to increase the audio if that will do. Oh. And disable screen scroll, I guess. Let me do that before I forget. I should probably just be making these edits as I go. Oh, it's because I had one apple off screen. That's funny.
I feel like I'm still sitting with really good posture right now.
You are. Bun went to the chiropractor yesterday and it helped a lot.
Hoo-wee, oh mama, it did. I'm sorry I started unironically saying that.
That's okay. It started as a reference.
It wasn't a reference! Well, it was a reference to myself.
Yeah.
To a clip of me. I don't think it counts as a reference if I'm a reference to myself.
I guess not. This is, like, barely negative 20. I'm actually going to put this in the negative 25 to negative 20 range, because this sounds fairly similarly leveled to Friends. You can also kind of tell because the sound effects are significantly louder than the in-game audio.
Also, this is the second Baja Blast of the day, I have to admit.
Oh.
The first one was a medium though, because I think I would have a large one.
Good job.
And good thing I had this one, because the first one, I could tell they were running out of the syrup at the end.
Mm.
There was just enough at the bottom that it was okay. But I was like running out on my drink.
Lame.
Good thing it was a medium though, because it would have been really messed up if it was large. It was at least drinkable. It was a little at the end that just got watered down. It was at least like the first hot day.
Yeah, it was actually pretty warm out today on my walk.
I got really sweaty on the walk earlier.
Oh.
What? I changed into shorts. I would have been dying in pants. I don't know why I thought I was gonna wear pants. Okay, sure. I had a weird smash on that. I yelled, okay, quick.
So good.
You know where it was, though. You see it. Those spasms.
I don't know how I made it up there, but okay. That jump off of that mole was surprisingly difficult. I might just have that mole be running already, because I think that mole, like, slightly falling there makes that harder than it needs to be.
Okay, hold on.
I heard already.
They're at boys' night, and some girls send some shots over, and they're like, sorry, you can't enjoy the free drinks because you say your wife can't enjoy free drinks. There's somebody got checked for him because that was bullshit. And he said that in the first place.
Yeah. Hi, Wiz. How's it going?
Wiz!
Good to see you.
How are you? How was Disney? You were at Disney, I think, right? I want to say the last time we talked, you were at Disney, or like the time before that. I feel like you went to Disney recently. Am I wrong?
I think I'm gonna have this first one also run a little bit more.
Being obnoxiously loud at this restaurant, I'm hoping my hockey team can win tonight. How cute are you? What hockey team do you like? I love that. Hockey's like one sport that's interesting to watch.
I've never super watched it, but I do remember when I was a kid at the Boys and Girls Club, the Sega Genesis had like three games. It had NHL 1994, Madden 1994, and like some not Sonic game that was a platformer that wanted to be Sonic. Vegas Knights? Nice. I've heard they're pretty good.
My sixth grade bestie, back in sixth grade, got me into the Red Wings. And I was like, I can never watch any other sport but this ever again. If there ain't teeth flying and people in penalty boxes, I want no part of it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maltby was my favorite. Okay, I had a favorite player. And it wasn't everyone else's favorite. Oh, I forget the name. I forget the name of everyone else's favorite player that year. But I was like, no, not me. I'll pick another guy.
I just will always remember my dad. Like, because my dad's, like, very into sports and, like, watched hockey when, like, Wayne Gretzky was, like, still doing his Wayne Gretzky things. And I remember it being on TV one day, and it was, like, late. It was like early 90s big screen TV, so it was super blurry. And my dad was like, hey, you're gonna remember this because Wayne Gretzky just made history. And I was like, okay. And I just like walked out of the room. I don't even remember what my dad witnessed that Wayne Gretzky made history for, because it turns out there could have been a lot of things, honestly. I mean, Wayne Gretzky kind of...
I literally think he has a song lyric right now, though, so I could be wrong.
He kind of has records for, like, literally everything, so yeah, it's hard to really identify.
He's like the Michael Jordan or whatever the current equivalent is.
I mean, more fairly, Michael Jordan's kind of like the Wayne Gretzky of hockey, because Wayne Gretzky kind of just, like, owns everything. And... Well, just the other way around,
gotcha.
Basically.
Okay. Where... I was thinking about seeing the difference. I'm sorry. It's the same picture.
Also, I guess depending on how long this playtest version of this goes, I might just move exits around since I am more interested in...
I just remembered our anniversary is this weekend.
Oh. Yes, it is.
For some reason, I thought it was next weekend still. And then I just saw the date, and then it's the 13th, and I was like, oh, 4 days from now. Okay.
Yeah. I don't super have anything planned for it, which I guess is why you don't really...
Yeah, I guess that's why. why. Well, because we have like Father's Day stuff planned for it.
Yeah.
Week long. It'll be
awesome. Yep. I mentioned this last week, but since it is next week, I'll go ahead and mention it again. Next week, I'm going to be on vacation all week, so I'll probably...
It was supposed to be this week, but...
Yeah, it was originally going to be this week, but then my new job made me kind of need to actually be in.
I mean, luckily our anniversary was on Saturday anyway, so it's not like it made it so you don't get our anniversary off, but...
Yeah. But yeah, it'll be nice. I'll be off the entire week, and we should be good to just chill. Yeah. Bun's gonna be going on a road trip on Wednesday.
Yeah, we're doing a summer solstice road trip. I keep doing this lately, just saying the wrong sounds and the wrong words from a different word in my sentence. But my bestie and I will be going on a summer solstice.
Yeah, so while Bun's out, we'll probably be doing a stream of something since I'll be kind of bored and alone all day.
Oh, what is it with Disney a few weeks ago? Getting all the people who say, oh,
did I, put a new clear? I don't remember if I put a new clear music in this or if I just left it alone.
Liz, were you, a little toasted? Did you have a few drinks? Why did they have to help you back?
Aww. I don't think I need that great platform there at all. I can clean up the end of this level a little bit, I think. I'll probably do that more later, but like just this last trick. Like I could probably put a ceiling there to assist with that. Yeah, because if there's a ceiling there, slash you know that you're supposed to re-grab there, that jump's pretty free, but if you have to figure it out yourself, it's hard. That's right, I didn't want to do a custom clear music, because otherwise it has to pause on like every single level clear. That's kind of a lot.
Yeah, there was a Taco Bell commercial I saw today that was saying that, like, Taco Tuesday is, like, copyrighted, so they kept beeping it out, and I was, like, really worked up about this. I was like, who has Taco Tuesday trademarked? And then they were like, but we're taking it back. No more bleeps. Taco Tuesday! And then they said it. And I'm just, I don't know if I was just really high, but I've never been more confused. It's okay, honey. Oh. I tried.
I think she heard you.
Do you know what the place they worked at that went to the hangout spot where people from movies Universal work at after hours? That's cool.
Yeah, that is cool.
I mean, you've made some cool Disney friends, Wiz.
Yeah.
I love it. Were, like, the drinks just, like, strong? Oh, the saddest little whimper sound I've ever heard! Oh. It's okay, honey.
So, if y'all didn't know, we met the dog next door. Her name's Honey. She's very cute and sweet and nice. And we aren't mad when she cries anymore because now
we just feel bad.
Yeah.
To be fair, we really just felt bad in the first place. And it was just also annoying. But like, annoying because I can't just like hear a dog being sad and like pretend I'm not hearing it, you know?
Yeah. How's it going, John? Good to see you. By the way, I for the audio level in this level, I think it's overall okay, but it could stand to be a little bit louder.
Wait, what? Wiz, that's so cool! The Quesarito commercial should be immortalized forever because the basketball player in Denver who won the championship was picked during that commercial. Oh, John, what a different name. Hey, John!
John with a name that just says John.
You know what? If it's pink and shows up with VIP, we know it's John.
My John's just called John.
John, you can't change the pink, though, otherwise we'll never know it's you. Well, I mean, your name is John right now, so we know.
But... We were discussing name color and how important it is
how
the other day.
How important name color is, yes.
Okay,
you
so...
You are pink, and any name, we know it's you.
How is Rusty Ruin Zone?
I mean, like, it's cool if you want to change it sometimes, but the worst for me is when people just have it set to the default where it just, like, changes the color every time, and it throws me off so bad. I wish the default would just pick a color for you, and then if you wanted to change it, you could change it. I don't know what this whatever color nonsense is. I don't know, I'm tired.
I'm usually really good at rank. I want to change the background hills in this level because I just saw this color is fairly similar to the platforms in this level.
I just, like, don't read in a wild name. Oh my god. Do you know you? Do they even go here? Fresno again, because I will lose my shit. Okay, no, it's good for a second. Does anyone else's, like, laptop and or phone just randomly decide that you're in a place that's, like, 100 miles away? It's not 100 miles away, like, in your state, but definitely not where you are?
This may be a more California-centric problem.
My laptop just keeps doing this, and I don't understand why I would ever think I'm in fucking Fresno, first of all. Second of all, I don't think I've ever brought this laptop to Fresno. Third of all, why would it ever think Fresno? I'm in Sacramento. Like, please. It makes no fucking sense. Like, I'll open a new tab to, like, look for something in my area, and it's like, search around Fresno? Oh, it was Weed Maps. I opened Weed Maps. And I was like, look around Fresno? I'm like, bitch, why? No! See, like, if I traveled with it, that'd be one thing. And I mean, I have brought this laptop to, like, Tahoe or something, but, like, I've never brought it to Fresno.
Yeah.
And then my phone did it one day, too. I don't know. It was bizarre.
Honey, it's not happy tonight.
It's okay for me.
Hey, Amber, how's it going? Good to see you, I tried to say, but I had literally no voice. Hope you're doing well. Should be ready for final testing soon, so station. We're doing an audio leveling one right now to make sure I don't blow anyone's eardrums out with an accidentally loud port. Also an exit check run, because I just realized I don't know if I actually have 24 or 25 exits.
He went out without his wedding ring on at boys' night. And they are all hella mad at him for it. What? This poor pupper is so sad. Mad at Theo? Who would be mad at Theo?
No, no, she's watching a reality show.
Oh, I'm coming. Sorry.
Yeah, no, Bun's watching a ridiculous reality show and commenting on it. I gotta be honest, I don't even know if I could take off my ring even if I wanted to, so.
Shanice just showed her boobs again for the second time tonight. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, sorry, you came into that after Bun had explained she was watching TV, I think, after.
I was explaining a thing earlier, I forgot to say I was watching TV then. Sometimes when Theo is streaming and I'm not streaming, when CO is streaming and I'm not streaming, I'm just watching a show.
Yeah.
So I watch dumb reality shows.
You know what we do need to watch is Avatar, please.
But like,
yeah. I even got it on Blu-ray now.
Maybe we can watch it, while you're off.
Maybe, this jump. I might just give another pipe here. I don't think this jump needs to be quite as hard as it is, especially since the actual timing is not really that tight. Oh. Oops. I fluttered, but too late.
Oh, now they're skinny to me. Oh, but the boys are getting hot.
Gonna call bullshit on that one. I thought I landed on the platform or fluttered and said I didn't either.
Ladyface, hi!
Hi, Ladyface, how's it going?
Maybe you should move that up a little bit so you can see the chat. Before you chat down a little since you don't have to see
my video. Yeah.
I know it's hard to compare, but like, a little bit higher, you know?
Oh my god, Chuck, please. I've been a while with you guys. Listen, Mom, how you doing? We're doing okay.
Yeah, how's your trip going?
How's your trip going? We had a good weekend, actually. We went to a pride thing over the weekend and had a good time with that.
Yeah, went to a pride parade. Apparently the pride event itself was like a paid event.
Yeah, and it was like only vendors and stuff inside,
yeah,
which like really made me question why it was a paid event.
There was just like nothing to... I didn't understand. I've been to San Francisco Pride before and you did not have to pay to get in. So like, I don't understand.
Yeah. But the actual, like, Pride Parade was fun. And then...
It was really great.
Yeah.
It was... really emotional. And I cried a lot, honestly. But, like, in a good way.
Yeah. Oh, that's no fun, Ladyface. I hope everything's okay.
Oh, what the fuck?
This port actually sounds okay audio leveled. I didn't actually check the overworld music, but I'm probably gonna get a lot of opportunities to do that in this.
Yelling at Simon. What'd he do? Oh my god, what did he do?
Oh my god.
What did he do?
I don't think I've ever heard this long into this port. I don't think I've ever one-shot that level before. We'll say that was a good audio level, actually, because I got to test that a lot. Okay.
Fair. Oh. He didn't do anything wrong. She said, if I get naked, is that okay? And he said, I would need to ask Bria. And that's all he said. And he didn't do anything. And then she just, like, took her whole bathing suit off and then went and jumped in the pool. But, like, he didn't do anything. And there were other people there. I'm very confused. Is something gonna get worse? Oh, well, now she's dancing in the hot tub and it's still there.
You are, Amber. I was saving you for nearly final testing.
Wiz, enjoy the rest of the game!
Oh, have fun!
I hope the knights will win!
As a Raiders fan, I feel a little allegiance to the Golden Knights as well, because they were really good the year we moved over there. I am not doing good at this.
Babyface, how was the mango milk green tea? That sounds good.
Oh, that does sound good.
With boba? That's 2-1. I'm hoping they can hold on. Hell yeah. Let me know if anything, like, fun happens. Let me know if someone loses a tooth. There's, like, a 4-on-4 fucking... It's not a power play anymore, but... You know what I mean? You know what I mean? It's a power play, someone's in the box, and then somebody else from the other team is thrown in the box, and then it's fucking 4-on-4. What do they call it? It's been a long time since I've watched hockey. Yeah, okay, I was right. I always love that shit. It's, like, so much more intense.
Okay, for some reason, I was just hitting these, like, way too high before. This level and trick are very particular. Which is why I've made sure to just give you unlimited time and as minimal amount of challenge here as possible, while still not just making it, like, do the exact same thing 5 times in a row.
Ready face, I was saying hockey was the only one that's interesting. I was trying to see you should pull your notepad up higher.
No! Damn it!
Sorry, I was checking.
It's okay.
Just so you can see your chat. You can't see your chat. It's stressing me out.
It's fine. I just look over and read it over there.
I know, but you can see when it pops in. Oh, good. I, like, thought I was into sports growing up, but... I don't know. People get, like, aggressive about, like, tastes. Like, I don't need it. So I got over that.
Yeah, the only one I'm really into is football, honestly, but...
Yeah. Well, and you're not the type to get aggressive about teams, so it's good.
You.
Lady Face, I literally was just sipping my Baja Blast. How did you know? I should probably hydrate with water. Now all I can think of anytime I drink something else is that thing from the chiropractor where it was like, what if you were bathing yourself in the coffee and soda and tea that you're drinking? What would your bathtub look like if that's what you're putting in your vital organs? And I was like, God fucking damn it, you're not fucking wrong. I wasn't asking to be called out like this, though.
Okay, I don't like that this trick's not feeling quite as consistent right now. You're supposed to just bottom left corner from left to right.
There's too much going on right now.
Maybe I'm just hitting it too high. It is like a super particular trick, but... I wonder how many people are gonna hate this exit. My guess is a lot. Uh oh. Alright, well, we got bailed out by RNG on this one. Which I'm okay with. If you put blocks at the top of the bonus game, it's soft lock. Oh, you know what? I did actually have that happen on one of my earliest tests of it. It must have been what happened. That's funny.
Also, Amber, I didn't see what you said. It was like a peeper that was trying to say, like lifestyle changes that you could be making for your body to be feeling better. And, like, one thing is to be drinking more water and cut out other drinks. And I guess they tried to compare it to, like, if you were trying to take a bath, and instead of a bath of water, it was, like, coffee or soda or tea. And then, like, that would be gross.
And, like, that would be gross. I fucked it up because I did it too fast. if you do that flutter, apparently it spawns in the last obstacle a little awkwardly. I guess that's good to know. See, that spawned much better that time. Weird. I'll have to look at that.
Bath of soda is the worst of those options. The coffee one, it would depend on how diluted the coffee is, I think, because that would be a real smell of coffee that you could not get off yourself. But the bubbles, no thank you. If I have to submerge my body in that, no. Coffee over bubbles, for sure.
Yeah.
Not my body parts. I'm sorry.
It's okay. I could have not said that part. You probably could have, it's okay.
Sorry, I got really, like, sensory distressed about it. Take a soak in this, babe. No! Dr. Pepper used to be my favorite soda, and now I cannot stand it. Thank you, COVID.
This is pretty solidly negative 20. I also changed this port since the initial round of testing because I accidentally triggered third wall because I used the port that was also used in Hacker's Dream's Ocean Stroll, and it was like right after he finished Ocean Stroll.
They barely blurred that box of Citrus Toast Crunch. I could tell exactly what it is.
Of all of the exits in the hack, this is the one that I'm, like, most contemplating a slight redesign of. Mostly to try to use the moles and bullets a little. Moles and bullets a little less, and to use the timed platforms and carrot platforms a bit more. It'd be a pretty radical redesign, but I'm open to it, mostly because I already have a level, or technically I have a level with both bullets and moles before this, and then I also have Bun's bullet level at the end of the hack, which is a better use of bullets than anything in this level anyway. The initial draft of this level being done in 4 hours was nice because I had a 4-hour design challenge in bunbun 2 as well, but I think I could potentially design a little bit more. I don't know, I'll let playtesters see how they feel about it and see if anyone even comments about it, but seeing as how each level is supposed to kind of have its like own unique theming, this is the only level in the hack it feels like it has like overlap really, outside of the castles and stuff, but the castles are intentional design overlap. This is just one of the earlier exits of bunbun, so. I'll probably keep this bullet chain just because this bullet chain actually lines up pretty nicely. Looking forward to testing things. I'm looking forward to having it out for testing. And the last time I had Bun 3 out for testing was in, like, December-ish, and a lot has changed about it since then, so. I had to have a round of testing by now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because otherwise I just wouldn't have been able to, like, it would have been way too overwhelming for me to try to incorporate everything.
Yeah.
Fun fact of this muncher right here serves no purpose other than to turn the mole around when he starts freaking out and spawning to the right for some reason. I had one random life during testing where he just like would not stop spawning going to the right and it irritated me, and then I added that muncher and he always turns to the left now. Oh yeah, and if anything is a shit kicker, honestly, please let me know, because,
this is supposed to be something that I should be able to play through at some point, yeah. So.
Well, and the way I've designed the hack, just as a heads up, I specifically designed it to avoid any, like, ridiculously long marathon levels.
Yeah.
Because one thing I noticed, especially at the end of bunbun 1, bunbun 2 doesn't really have it quite as much. But Culmination Castle into the Bowser fight of bunbun 1 is a little rough on players, and it was meant to kind of just be like a fun end to the hack, and instead it was a little tiring. So I tried to avoid that this time and kind of spaced out the review segments throughout the rest of the hack. Which hopefully means that nothing should take people a terribly long time. I'm not gonna lie, I completely forgot it to go for it. I had every intention of going for it, and then I just ran for the goal. Yes.
Wait.
Moot.
That doesn't work though, unless you do it like.
Uh. It's like peaking at negative 15, but this feels more like negative 20. So let's go ahead and plan on mapping that one as well. As a reminder, when I randomly pause like that, I'm leaving notes for myself for audio leveling. I'm basically just looking at my waveforms in OBS and trying to see roughly what my audio is like peaking at for in-game audio with me not doing anything. And we will hopefully be leveling everything to a baseline of negative 15 decibels according to this volume I'm at right now. It's more important that everything is consistent rather than everything being like super loud, because players can like adjust their audio settings or whatever. I don't like people having to adjust their audio settings like level by level. I just do it right now. It also gives me another round of playtesting. And especially for bunbun 3, I need pretty much every round of playtesting I can get because of character switching the entire time. Because I can almost guarantee there's not really the exact same way I'm playing any of these segments in between rounds. Which I think will be fun for players, because I think as they start to get more comfortable with it, they're just gonna kind of... I would imagine most players are gonna probably main Mario and then switch to Bun as needed for flutters and like saves and stuff, but that's kind of the goal anyway, so... Can technically save that. It's very hard to do that. Oh my god, I forgot my part from any transition over into this music, so I'm just gonna wait for it to get back in on the chorus so I can see the audio leveling a little better. That like intro drum roll is a little louder, but I don't think I'm gonna count that because it doesn't look as well. It is the last bite.
Yep. Oh.
half my.
Nope, you're full.
Cool. I like that sound effect for the victory stuff.
Why is he so controlling to her? This is rubbing me the wrong way, for real! He told her don't wear fucking a certain outfit unless you're wearing heels with it, because it doesn't look good with flats. What? I'm sorry. The audacity of men, though, is all I'm
gonna say. Okay. How is the several music? So we're doing 20. Okay. Also negative 20. I have to turn up redial. I can probably get the clouds in the background of this level, but I think I kind of like it being clean sky for this level and then clouds for the rest of the world. A version of redial working in bunbun 3. For those that don't know, this song and I have had a pretty complicated history. I've wanted this song in the game ever since bunbun 1, and for bunbun 1 and bunbun 2, I had issues getting the samples to work correctly. Like, it just really wouldn't work in AMK for some reason. So I never got it actually working, and then for bunbun 3, when I was actually working on the music tutorial thing that I put up on my YouTube to, like, just port, or not port stuff, but just get ports into the game, I decided to try the other redial by Diffy, and it worked, like, perfectly fine, so excited that that's finally in the game, because redial is good. -25 to -20. Is it different something louder? Not really. Unless it does in chorus. Okay. Meh. I can stand to come up. Okay. I would say this level probably went through the biggest, like, graphical overhaul throughout all of bun3. Oh, I see a leaf in the background. Get rid of that. It's clouds now. Shoutouts to D4 for these pipes, by the way. Shoutouts to D4 for a lot of stuff, but shoutouts to D4 for the pipes and the ghost ropes that we used in the last level, actually. I drew the graphics for him, but he wrote the very good code for him, so. Oh! Okay. Fix that wall, I guess. Are all of my walls fucked up like that? Yes. Okay, so that's map 16 thing. That's fine. Are these fucked up too? No, just the ones up there. Is why you test. I mean, ultimately, it doesn't really change anything, but I do like you having the ability to brush up against the walls and stuff. Does that mean I got the vertical slopes correct, but not just like the regular wall? That's hilarious. Good on me for making sure the slopes worked. Bad on me for making sure anything else worked. That is very backwards. That is not the way it's supposed to be. Hey, Brad, how's it going? Good to see you. Hope you're doing well. Cutting up cardboard boxes. Sounds fun. Oh, yeah, you went on more walking. I'm sorry, little bun.
All I can think is because my socks kept slipping.
And
like...
Yeah. Yeah, Brett just got here.
You know, scum better stay away.
Catching up to the spiny again is actually kind of hard. Me too, although honestly it can be dark with my webcam on apparently and it looks fucking perfectly fine. I don't know why.
It's like your monitor, like
the laptop monitor. I keep forgetting these clouds are death and I can't brush against them. I apparently used that wall to line up my shots a lot. Yeah, we,
Don't have these people say no, for real.
We kept our wedding very small, and even then we still had... I hope some people say no. Oh no, an ad! Sorry, I can't tell when ads are going. I have to have OBS positioned very specifically today for audio leveling stuff. Oh. Yes? Bam! Yes, those lists are very annoying, Brad. We agree. Is what we were saying through the ad. Welcome back from the ads, by the way.
On the list and it's on the East Coast, we'll say no, but like in a regrettable way. Like, wish we could come. So there's a no for you.
I don't think he was wanting us to be a no.
Well, I don't have money, so.
Oh.
Yeah, that's basically what weddings are.
Yeah. It's kind of... For a lot of people, being invited is the important part. Like, obviously for close friends, also celebrating the fact that y'all are... Yes. If there is a California reception, we will 1000% be there.
We would make it to that, yes. I wish that we could travel. I would be there in a heartbeat.
Oh my god, I switched over in time and then I just missed the spin jump? Okay. This segment is not as hard as I'm making it look, by the way.
Especially because you came to our California reception. And you weren't even still in California at the time.
It's true.
And you had to leave early because you were on East Coast time and also got accidentally tequila. Oh. But like, that's neither here nor there.
Gonna be all mountainy and during peak leaf change. Oh, that does sound pretty.
Aww.
Aww. Also, speaking.
What is it gonna be? Yes. I mean, fall, obviously, but like. Your parents drove to San Francisco to
That's
pick
so
you up.
Far for them. What the hell?
What the hell? We would have done that. Okay, next year. I mean, that gives us some time.
Okay.
I need to figure out when Melissa's wedding is going to be, too, because she's at least in California. But we have to go to hers, too. They just got engaged, though, so...
Whiz!
Dead!
Six to one? Are you kidding me?
Vegas is winning 6-1, I cannot contain myself.
Who are they playing? I have so many questions! Sorry, this is the one sport you'll actually get me talking about.
They said we want the extra 4 hours of seeing you, that's fair.
Aww.
And also adorable.
Aww.
Well, congratulations, Wiz. That's
we
a big
care
deal.
With you, Wiz.
Yeah, we'll care here.
We are here to celebrate.
It's hockey.
The Vegas Knights.
Also, I think that's the first time we've seen the Lingbo Dead alert, so thank you for the goodies, Wiz.
Bro, this is clearly hockey talk.
Hockey talk.
Only hockey talk. I'm just kidding. You can talk about it. I don't want you to think I was being serious for some reason. I don't know if hockey talking could ever be serious, but if it was, it wasn't.
U.S. hockey teams. Yawn. That's the most Canadian thing
that
I've maybe ever heard
Canadian
you say, Amber.
That was the most Canadian bullshit I ever did see. I fucking loved that. Oh wait, Brad, you moved? Wait, is that where the new house is?
I think so.
And your old place was closer to there? I mean, you didn't move it, right?
I'm still astonished that I got the walls right for the bottom part of all of these, and for the slopes, but not for, like, leaves. Like, how did I miss that?
That was Egypt?
It's a little hot, but, you know.
A roller skating commercial? I'll kill you! Is this for Taco Bell? Taco Bell with the ads, dude! Give your marketing people a raise, Taco Bell, I'm telling you. Every time I see a cool commercial, it's Taco Bell. They've had one miss out of like 10 hits lately. Like 9 out of 10 were hits. One was a miss. I forget what it was because it was so horrible. But the other ones have been really good. Roller skates? How dare you? I want to skate. I hope so bad that this will help my hip and I can just fucking skate again. Maybe I would stop losing my mind so often. Taco Bell got that beans money. They got that cheese gordita crunch money.
I don't know if you can actually make that on the first life, but if it's an intentional death, it's whatever.
Okay.
into CGC.
Oh. Also, hi. How are you? How's it going? I'm kind of snuck in, but...
Oh my god, I thought that was Amper! I saw a capital A, a capital S, and what looked like red, but is definitely pink.
Wow.
And what looked like red...
Amper's name is more pink. It's like a pinkish red. Hold the fucking phone.
And what looked like red...
Oh, she's agreeing. Crunch, literally, Arya just agreeing with me, and I'm like, what is that? Arya, do you use the Taco Bell app? I am not sponsored by them, so I really should not be saying any of this without fucking compensation.
Don't you dare speak their name without compensation.
But on the app, you can get the box, the create your own box, and you can get it with a cheesy gordita crunch, and then I get it with the beefy five-layer burrito.
I told you about the box.
Then why are you saying it's so expensive? Because it's not. If you get it in the box, it is if you get it on its own.
It's like the price of the box if you get it without the box.
For real. But yeah, why are you buying it standalone? Wait until you get your points and then redeem a free one if you need an extra.
That's so annoying, Brad. I'm sorry. Shouldn't be on you to explain the horrible Discord rollout. I was a little sad I didn't get CEO, but I got CEO Cadelic at least, so it's
sliding
fine.
Into your DMs? I can't.
That's so funny.
Yeah, someone had Princess Bunbun, which, I mean, I figured probably they would, but I got Princess Bunbun _. Oh my god, Arya, I'm really fucking tired today. I'm so sorry. I'm taking you, like, so seriously right now.
Yeah, we were gonna do some Yoshi tonight, but...
I went for a walk with my mom, and then we, like, laid out at their pool for a bit today. And I was in the shade for most of the pool time, but the walk was really in the sun, and I didn't realize how sun tired I got. So I got home and I'm now just like sitting in a cave of darkness with only fairy lights on.
Yeah.
Fairy lights and a salt lamp. If that isn't like a bun mood, I don't know what is.
That death finally happened again. So you can kind of clip into the, specifically the vertical moving pipes here. And in every other instance of the level, I have just like the vanilla, like, ascending pipes, because those don't have that issue. But I specifically need the custom up pipe there, because I need it to, like, not eat that top tile, otherwise the obstacle just doesn't, like, really work.
Did you accidentally cut the foam? You said you were cutting cardboard boxes, right?
Like... Yeah. The good news is that death doesn't happen often enough. But I think it's gonna be a huge issue.
A drum kit.
That's cool.
Boy, that is amazing. James. James has had a lot of yells lately.
Freaky. Daddy.
Woo woo. Woo woo.
You guys are getting better. I don't know how I made it in that door, but okay. I, like, clipped onto the side of the pipe and then, like, just barely landed on there. Alright. You say so, game.
When was Impulse's birthday? Did we miss it? Happy birthday.
Happy belated birthday. I'm assuming we did. If Impulse got birthday gifts.
Did we miss it? Happy birthday.
Okay, where...
Also, Arya, did we even ask how you are? First, we... thought you were somebody else, and then I was like, why are you saying it's expensive? Just get it in the box. I didn't ask how you are. Hello. Wonderful to see you. How are you?
I'm gonna say this is negative 20 to negative 15. It's kind of trending more towards negative 20. And oh, it's negative Okay. So you're retired from the game.
Are they supposed to, like, maybe even out soon?
Yeah, I have to take my armor on when I'm going to bed, because otherwise it makes me too sleepy. It's been weird since you got back from BBQ.
Like a jet lag kind of thing? On top of it?
You can get a little bit of a cycle skip there if you don't go all the way up through the roof.
The time zone change for you, right? From like mountain to central? I wanna say.
Yeah.
Like, I would be exhausted for, like, weeks. Would be worth it, but I would be exhausted for weeks.
But it's over!
Yeah, I believe that.
Damn it. Yeah, I can imagine.
I'm bad at traveling, I'm bad at crowds, I'm bad at a lot of things. That's why the meme of AGDQ being in Sacramento, I was like, oh, yeah. JK of less. Literally be perfect for me, but.
There you go, Amber. I got the moon and then died. That's for skipping the moon and the other one. That one was just for you. Oh. I keep meaning to switch to bun there, because you sometimes get a little, like, gimpy jump off of the Koopa. And if you don't get, like, the full jump off of them, it helps to be able to, flutter from bun, because I think it's just enough height to be able to make it from there. It's pretty tight still, but you can only make it. Looking down at the port, it definitely seems like it sticks around negative 20. But given the louder parts of the port actually peak up to negative 15, I'm not 100% sure how much will change this one. That is not what I meant to do. Swamp unkillable with the throw block. You know, I never actually checked, so let me do that. Honestly, if you can kill it with the throw block, I don't know if I super care. But like, I always forget that swamp kills with throw blocks or like. Yeah, I was gonna say, it doesn't really change that much, but I am curious. I forgot it's like a 50-50 basically, depending on what. Was it a sprite roll? I don't even know what it actually is, honestly. I know it comes up in storks a lot, but that's
it's like the only time I ever really see it being super relevant. Yeah, I think it's good. Sprite slots, yeah.
Fucking funny every time because the bar like curves out towards like where people are coming up to ask for a drink for some reason. Like, that's a really weird design choice for a place where people are drunk. But anyway, she just like walks up to it and bounces out.
Yeah.
Describing it well, but it's fucking hilarious.
Don't think it's a regrab from the platform, despite me doing a regrab over and over again. Why did I try to jump around? Okay. That I got to pretty much reuse this background in the final castle with like very minor edits. Okay.
Until I'm actually tired, that was a real yawn. Like a real, like, I'm sleepy yawn because my eyes got watery.
Yeah.
And my eyes get so watery when I'm, like, laying in bed trying to fall asleep and I don't know why.
Yeah.
It's, like, really annoying. I have to keep wiping it a million times.
This is the only part of the game I'm not, like, 100% sold on. Especially now that this is more of a cloud world and not, like, a forest world. And it's a pretty chill Crash Bandicoot, so. Pretty quiet too. Let's say -25 to -20, and maybe I'll like it more if it's louder. Of all of the musical selections in the game, I think this is the one that I'm like most likely to change before release. I still like it, but I'm not like as in love with it as I was when this was the forest level. It is kind of a nice break in terms of the music, I guess, because the music of World 3 is a little on the intense end. It's kind of nice to have a more chill port for the slower climbing level. Thank you. That jump's gonna fuck people up.
Come at a cost. I knew.
No! Damn it.
Yeah, I guess they had like a donation pickup thing at my street today, and there was like this like desk chair that I saw that I like turned around to like peep at a little bit closer, and then I didn't take it, and then I was like, let's see if it's still there on the walk, and then it wasn't. They already came and picked it up, but I don't think it would have fit under that desk anyway.
Probably not. The desk is really short.
Well, and just the way that the chair was, I don't think it would have been able to, like, push in all the way. And it had a couple of little, like, rips and tears in it, you know?
Yeah.
So I was just like, not worth trying to get to the car. But I thought about it.
Well, thanks for thinking of it, I guess.
Of course. Well, I was just looking at the desk and being like, I don't think it was going to work. Because it was just the kind where it had, like, arms that kind of come up from the bottom to the top that are at kind of an angle.
Yeah. So
my arms kind of pod-looking chair, almost? I don't know. It was cute, but the white probably also wouldn't have matched the white of the desk, let's be real.
This port is perfect as it is. Ideally, I will be leveling every port to this port, basically, for those who are curious. I'm not sure if I'm actually able to do that, because it does depend on the ports if I'm actually able to, but... Oh my god. Unexpected, interesting thing with this level now that I am in Uber ASM retry. To retry the level for this level, you have to hit start. Because A and B are disabled. And I didn't think that was going to carry to the retry part, but it did. Kind of funny, also a little annoying. It's not the end of the world, it's just kind of hard to remember, and I might need to put like a note about it or something. It is kind of funny though. I'd say it's more of an LOL without caps, personally. So honestly, the A and B being disabled in this part in the retry prompt is unironically actually kind of a funny way to tutorialize that A and B are disabled for this level. Because in order to retry the level, you're gonna have to hit a button. And it's not a soft lock or anything, so I would just retry this. Actually reset it. There's a little bit of a fast fall there to be able to actually do that, and then if you just run forward here, you're fine. If you panic, you then have to time it out, but if you just run forward here, you're fine.
Whoa! Sorry, it was a Mario pipe in the middle of their living room while they were playing Mario Kart! Let's go! Mario World! I didn't see that's how this one started, sorry.
It's okay.
Oh, we saw once they were already there.
Nice, I'm glad I don't have to switch this port. That is the damn VP for allowing me to use this port again. I requested this port for Borgie and Mai's GDQ level last year, and have wanted to use it in bunbun 3 since then, and then finally got up the nerve to ask Dan, and he was very okay with it. So does that mean that, yeah, it is disabled in here too? That's funny. Hey Cam, thanks. Going pretty good so far, honestly. Hope you're doing well. There's got to be a way to re-enable A and B presses after you've died in this screen, I would imagine. It's at least, like, not very far after the other no-jump segment, so you should remember at that point that you just have to start to go through them. Don't know how I made it over that fire part. Okay, I actually haven't tested this with a mushroom, so let's do it since I have this switch. Looks like second port is also good on volume. Actually, something I want to test here. Did I leave counter break on accident? I dig that clear music, but it needs to be slightly louder. I do see that I'm still big in the cutscene, but I'm not sure if counter break actually applies before or after that. Hmm.
I did leave counterbreak on. Whoops. Does that change anything? Not really, because it's the water level next, right? Yeah, it actually kind of does, because you have to... No, also you can't get through this obstacle without being small anyway, so... I guess it gets you through that obstacle. Might change that. I'm not sure if I want to go the direction of leaving counterbreak in. Wait, that was just a weird spawn of the retry behind the seaweed, I guess. This port might actually be on the loud end. This is looking like negative 15 to negative 10. Not sure if I'm actually going to adjust the volume on this one, but it is, like, slightly louder. Sure does, Arya.
I don't know what that is.
The song that's going on right now. I should probably just put that midway in this room. I didn't realize that was a pipe entrance. It's because I don't think it was before. But that's okay, I can just put a midway entrance in here and then just heavy spawn in the room. That's what it's supposed to do. Most of these comments I'm making to myself, by the way, are comments that I'll just, like, fix before this region goes out for final testing. I'm just making the comments, so I can just do it later. Because an entire goddamn island is coming up, so. Oh.
This one also looks like it's good. Exactly why I put that dragon there, if I'm being honest. That one at least makes sense. To like this obstacle because I don't know what I was doing with this one, to be honest. Okay, I think that obstacle just worked better if it was just two dry bones instead of that dry beetles in the second spot. There's another level that I'm kind of whatever about outside of the last trick, honestly, but.
Outside.
I don't know.
So I'm gonna lose it.
I'm gonna wait for the whistle part of this before I write down. Okay, that's definitely negative 20, compared to negative 20. Oh, right. Change this too. So far out of all of like the level revision edits that I've made, the only ones that I've noticed that I need to go back and do again are the last levels, which isn't too bad. Thank you. late there for sure. Cool. Okay. Might look into trying to get rid of the exit prompt, but I also don't know if that's gonna fuck with the retry level. But going down and hitting exit is a little annoying. Chat love. How's it going, Abel? That ending jump looks scarier than it actually is. Hope you don't love it. The visuals for this level that I like them a lot more. Fits the port a little better too, I think. Gotta change that. Okay. Thank you. should have just stayed as bun. Dang. After this level, I think I'm gonna need to take a break, and then we will finish up the rest of testing when I get back. It's been about 2 hours anyway, so. Go ahead and see. Let me do an exit break when we're not here. But... Thanks, Ari. I hope you're going well. Alright, so we have 1, 2, 7 levels left, I think. Let's go ahead and try to just blast through. I realized I actually forgot to write down the audio for this. I think it was okay. Okay, that's fine. Okay. As a reminder, we are still in the middle of our audio leveling run right now, so... It's also an exit check, actually, because I don't exactly know how many exits are in the game. I think it's 25, but it very well could be 24. it looks like this first port's at negative 20. That's pretty solid. I think it's 20. Okay. Shout out to D4 again for these blocks. D4 may not know how much she made happen for bunbun 3, but she made a lot of bunbun 3 happen, so.
And not like petting their dog to greet them. That dog is following you around so much. Fucking pet it. It wants a pet.
It wants a pet?
Like, please. I can't imagine going to somebody's house and not like petting their dogs before I even say hi to them. And then I say, oh, right. Hello, humans. And make a joke about it.
Yep.
Every single time.
You may think Bun's exaggerating when she says every single time, but it is not an exaggeration.
Yep. Whenever we see our friends in the chat, that's the verified.
You do
too. You do too? Okay, good. At my parents' house specifically, though, I like have to ignore Gracie at first, because otherwise she'll pee a little bit when I pet her.
Yeah.
Like, I have to let her calm down first.
You said she was extra excited to see you today, yeah. Though.
That's I had to ignore for a sec, though, because we were going to keep it, then we just went outside in the backyard. Calm down. Because I was looking at the pool first.
And then you were able to acknowledge her, and she's like, yeah. Finally!
Well, because she stays on the patio.
Oh.
She doesn't come over by the pool yet. They have to teach her, like, how to get out of the pool and stuff.
That's good.
So right now, they're teaching her to stay away. I mean, I feel like dogs instinctively kind of figure out how to swim, but...
I think it's more.
I don't know if she's really gone swimming before.
I was gonna say, I think it's more just teaching her to be able to use the steps to, like, right. Get out and stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't think she's really gone swimming unless they've gone swimming.
But they're extra careful about it because they told you about our dog who was old and would fall in the pool sometimes and
face out. Yeah.
Extra careful about her to teach her. All the things.
That's good.
Yeah. I should add, I only said that because the dog was just fine. By the way. I wasn't trying to tell, like, a super traumatic story and just drop that. Like, years old when I was a child, obviously he ended up dying, but like, he was okay.
Spoilers!
Trauma dumping? Fuck you.
Yeah, I don't know if y'all saw that, but...
the end of my, like, last stream?
Yeah, it was at the end of, like, a pretty chill night of us just, like, chilling and doing bun-bun design and playing Breath of the Wild. And, like...
And it was, like, while I was, like, on my, like, full webcam, like, while I was ending and the raid was about to go through.
Yeah.
And, like, I think... Like, were they trying to tell me that I was trauma dumping?
I'm low-key convinced they said it in the wrong chat.
Yeah.
Like, they were just, like, really lurking.
Or they, like, read my rules that said, like, not to trauma dump in the chat, and then just said, trauma dumping, fuck you.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, okay. But
someone who, like,
I don't know what you mean.
Had chatted in Bun's chat before wasn't, like, a frequent viewer, but, like, it wasn't a first-time chat.
I don't know. Below 10 chats had been sent in the chat, you know?
But and someone just drops a...
Looking back on them, they were never, like... you know, constructive to the channel.
Yeah.
But it just made me laugh so hard because I was like, all I said was like, I'm not going to be streaming on Tuesday because I'm going to my parents' house. Is that trauma dumping? Like.
So then we banned and moved on, but it was a very weird.
Sorry,
end
I had
stream.
To just make a joke about it. I'm still thinking about it because like, what did you mean? And then, like, the raid went through, you know what I mean? Like, I couldn't even ask what they meant. And then I was scared they were gonna be on, like, the raid with us. You know? It'd be weird.
I might need to look at this obstacle before, because I think this spawn is being weird for it. Yeah, because I think if you do that spawn differently, that trick after at the end becomes really hard. How's the audio on this one? Negative. And 25 and negative 20, it looks like. I don't know, that was a lot.
People need to stop thinking that, like, flashy shit is what they should put in their shows. How many Caesars did they trigger? How many little Caesars did they trigger as well? Baby, you left this light on.
Oops. You're moving to the ocean. GG, lit. Also, hi. Okay, so I have to look at the midways for the water level and this level. Because for some reason it moved them, like, a transition backwards.
Oh.
But that's exciting. I hope you have fun. Out of curiosity, what drove that decision? So, this music won't be resetting like this over and over again because you'll just be in this room. I love the... I mean, fair. The ocean is good. Oh. Oh, yeah, if it's free rent also, then swoop up on that. It's a very good deal. That kill me. Weird. You have six dogs? That sounds like a fun time. Are you keeping one of the puppies? Do you know which one yet, or is it just going to be whichever one doesn't end up getting adopted?
Oh,
pretty solidly negative 15 decibels, so I don't need to adjust the volume on this one at all. These Koopas are off by a tile. I'll fix that. Oh, yeah, the midway is just super funky for this level. Okay. Well, good thing I found that in this round of testing. So I'm gonna have to fix that for sure.
Oh, I have tan lines from my shorts, cause my legs are burnt!
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I just need to play.
So I guess in my defense, this is the first time that I've used this retry in a full hack, so there were bound to be a couple of instances, I guess, of me needing to fix stuff. The good news is, this version will be very easy to test, once I've completed the save. How's it going, Mama? Good to see you. Bun just, started showering, whatever she would say hi. But hope you're doing well. Good to see you. Here's that. Well, whoa. We are testing the audio levels of all of our segments, and I guess also testing how the retry is actually functioning for the whole game. Because I need to tweak it a little bit. This should just be same music. Is this a... Am I using this anywhere? Yes, I am. Okay. It's like, why am I hearing a new port in here? Change 161 music to above. Retry fix for water level. -20. Yeah. the good news is the music isn't, like, super far off. It's mostly just kind of quiet in a couple of spots. You mostly just don't want your music, like, hella loud in one spot and then, like, non-existent in another. You picked a good world to come in on, because there are a lot of enemies in this world. To the point where I almost thought about trying to add them to the overworld, but I don't really know how to add custom overworld sprites. I guess I could try to learn before release, but there's not really like a ton of like customized stuff for the overworld in general. Unless I just haven't looked in a while. That re-grab under there is pretty gnarly, honestly. It doesn't look like anything, but when you're playing it, it feels pretty tight. Oh my god, I actually died to the spike? Holy shit. I was like just about to say, and the spike is looser than it looks like it is, and you normally cut the jump short there, but apparently you can't. I was in fact pencil. How's it going, dude? Oh my god. Now I'm just in my head. I didn't need to I didn't need to jump that early at all. The ice and the yeah, so basically these are what I like to call freeze blocks. I forget what they're actually called in SMW Central. But they're a remnant of my KLDC level from like 2 years ago where it was like semi-ice stuff everywhere. And these blocks are in the second segment of the level, I think, where you have to kind of time freezes and stuff. I actually saw that Cam mentioned the hack earlier, the Joker Street, or the Joker Shell, okay, by Miso has a level where you freeze both yourself and sprites, which is pretty fun. But see, that's the regrab I'm talking about, right here at the bottom. But levels are looking cool, thank you. This is the first time I've sat down and done, like, one full playthrough of the game, so overall, it feels pretty good. There's like one or two very minor things that I need to fix. But honestly, I kind of knew there was going to be stuff I needed to fix. And the fact that there's not as much as I was worried there would be is nice. Their physics thing. Yeah, when I saw these blocks on SMW Central, when I'm like looking for stuff on SMW Central for making a level out of, typically like I won't download something unless I have like an actual idea of what I want to do. These freeze blocks, I had like absolutely no clue what I wanted to do, but I downloaded them and was like, I hope I can figure out a segment for them. And now they've actually become one of the favorite blocks that I've found from this game. They're not, like, super versatile in what you can do, but you can actually force a pretty fun amount of jumps with them, seeing as how all they do is, like, temporarily stop your movement. Thank you. Okay, so the midway here might also be a little fucked up. I'm not exactly sure what's fucking up the midways, if I'm being honest. Let me die in here and actually see where it takes me. No, this one works fine. How odd. There must just be like a couple of vanilla midways I'm using throughout that are complicating things. Because I think all of the midways that I have set with secondary entrances and stuff are fine. Oh, I meant to add a Kaizo, an outlined Kaizo there. I guess it's not like the end of the world, but I've done it everywhere else in the hack. Might as well add these graphics there too. And also the 1F0 ropes. The 1F0 ropes might be a little harder though, just because I don't think there's been anywhere where I combine the 1F0 ropes and the slippery cloud like that. And they kind of share visual, like, style. Where does this take me? Okay, so all the midways in this level are fine.
What?
Not sure what that was, but sounded silly. It's a cool use of disco shells, thank you. I am okay at disco shell writing, but it's like not one of my like Kaizo strengths, I would say. I kind of want to change this ending, potentially. I feel like there's a better ending I can do with these slope, or with these ice mines and stuff on this. But yeah, when I thought of the ending for the water level, I figured that would be a good way to reincorporate the disco shell from the disco and conveyor level. For those that don't know, basically all of the castles in this game are like brief summations of the levels that come before them in the world. You like the not your blasting thunder? Yeah. Shoutouts to whoever posted that sprite on SMW Central forever ago. Took a little bit of getting used to, because you have to kind of design around it. Like you can see that it's flashing in front of like the background and stuff. So I had to draw like a bunch of not background, but actually background to cover the screen, because otherwise it was just like eye-piercingly black to white every time it flashed. And like the X animation specifically flashes from black to white, so it wasn't even like I could do like a cloudy sky or whatever. So if you're wondering why there's like this like rock tower wall and stuff, you can kind of see more what it would look like up here, where like the entire screen starts to flash a little bit more. It would have been like this for the entire room, which would have been a lot to deal with. Wonder what happens if you skip that midway, because honestly, I think you might actually get sent back a room. Okay, I think actually, this port is slightly louder. Yeah, I don't realize. Yeah, shout out to Russian Man for this boss. Oh my god, what a snipe! Holy shit! Oh, that was brutal. He always starts in this spot because of the way you enter the room. And there it's RNG, I think. Oh my god! Sniped again. I might need to allow a couple more hits on this part by like maybe raising the ceiling a little bit more. I think I can stand and nerf this. I want you to be at least like attempting hits on the side, and right now attempting hits on the side is like almost a death sentence. Yeah, we actually have a decent amount of Sonic in the hack. Ironically enough, the custom song of the level that we used up until the actual Sonic music is called Sonic Sucks. Yo, what the fuck? Why did you take so long? I got one more shot. I gotta go wherever he's at. Oh no, it cuts off before the last note. It's okay. I just always assume that you can't hear and then just type in chat anyway. Okay, so this port's weird because the bum 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 in the background is peaking at like negative 15 or negative 10, but like the main melody of this is like pretty consistently around negative 25. How is this port such a wide range of volumes? You can hear them evenly. Okay, maybe this one's fine then. Yeah, I'm doing pretty good. I had a really busy, long day at work, honestly, but we're just chilling now. Okay. I assume you meant the Overworld song. It's a Kingdom Hearts song. It's called Dearly Beloved. That's the song that plays in the beginning when you're, like, selecting your save file and stuff. The one that is on right now is a Snowboard Kids 2 port. Yeah, I think it's more just I was hearing it at different audio levels, and it might just also have a wide range for that one.
Oh. What? How did you do that?
You've never done that before, Dino Rhino. Why'd you do that time? Yeah, it's supposed to do that, where it turns around and just slides that way. That's literally the first time I've seen him just, like, get through that contraption, but then turn left anyway. Thank you for the club, Mario. I will, I'll look at that offline, but I don't entirely understand. Yeah, I forgot to mention it, and I guess I should mention it since I've been back. I intentionally have the in-game audio very loud today, because I am audio leveling. And honestly, if you hear anything that is needing to be audio leveled, such as the level being a lot louder than me or whatever, please feel free to shout that out, because that is helpful. I did think that this one was at least louder than the other level, but maybe I won't touch this port then. How's it going, Fall Circus? Good to see you. I think I have one of your ports in the hack now, if I remember right. Although it's interesting that you say that, because I was planning on potentially turning this one up a little bit, because it's like consistently around negative 20. Okay, I did pull down my microphone. Also, Fire Bun Sprite is adorable. Yeah. Borgie killed it again. Shooting Star Summit is looking like it's... So these two ports are leveled together, basically. I think this one has less of, like, a range. But... why are you taking so long to get over here? Weird, you normally don't have to do- this must be another quirk of the Uber ASM retry, because you typically didn't have to wait that long. I might need to adjust that slightly. No! Because, like, it's meant to be where you just jump and go over, but it's, like, ever slightly off. Like, it's not the end of the world, but I don't really like having to, like, force the player to wait there when there's not, like, really a reason to. Especially since I'm pretty sure I can just move that Dino Rhino, like, one up. If you grab the Yoshi instead of just the little moth aside. Oh. There's a couple different ways you can do that last jump. The way I did it is probably the hardest, where you just jump straight for it. But you can also hit the dolphin on the way up and kind of like flutter stall if you need to. Also, I guess... I haven't mentioned it, but there should be no forced switching in the entirety of, like, the regular game, outside of the bun-only level. Which isn't even technically like a bun-only level, it's just meant to be like a bun learning level, since most of the jumps are like much easier with bun. Yeah. Wash the skin off. You did ask, but I'll mention it again. You cannot steal a cloud from a Lakitu unless you kill it with a shell or like a turn block or something. And I have it set up in the level where you can't do that until it's intentionally supposed to be so.
Hi, Momo.
Yeah. No, it's okay. Lakitus and SMW specifically are really weird. I think in Mario Maker it might be easier to steal the cloud from. but in SMW it's like very specific on when you're able to actually take the cloud from them and when they just die. And then come back and then die again. In my opinion, it actually makes it a lot easier to design like a Lakitu segment because of that. Because if you had to constantly worry about players suddenly being able to fly with a cloud anytime you put one in a level, you might run into issues. Oh, I'm down too. It's just the cloud specifically is like super powerful and kind of its very own movement tech. There's a lot of cool stuff you can do with clouds, actually. Third Wall specifically designs a lot of cool stuff with clouds. Because they are kind of really their like own thing in Super Mario World. It's almost kind of like its own platform, and not like a power-up, if that makes sense. So like, when you're in a cape, you can kind of hold things, run around, do whatever you do. You just also have the added benefit of being able to move up and down freely, and then also like jump out and jump back into the cloud and stuff. Yeah, the floating aspect is by far the hardest thing to design around with. No! I didn't see that he threw another one, god damn it. I would have been fine. I didn't see that he threw that second one, like, pretty much right after the Yoshi showed up. Yeah, but that sounds like a floating platform is broken, it's because it is. And that's also why you don't really see a ton of, like, SMW Kaizo use Lakitu, I think. honestly, I think Lakitu overall is kind of an underexplored vanilla sprite. He kind of takes up a lot of room, and you have to, like, definitely design a level, like, around him. But he's a pretty cool dude. What? How did the ocean eat that? I don't know.
That's hilarious. Sometimes I just don't feel like dealing with the sensory of it all, you know? It's like hot water, cool water. It's so wet.
Yeah. Wonder what kind of puzzle room you could do with it. Some pretty gnarly stuff. You can be pretty precise with Kate or with Cloud movement if you want to be. I've never really asked the player to be, like, super precise with their Cloud movement. Like, I think the end of this level is probably the most precise I've ever asked you to be with a Cloud, and even then it's not really, like, that precise. Well, thank you, Yoshi, for saving me there. I don't know if this is gonna be the final hit or not. Okay, it was. No! Lakitu again! saved and then later destroyed by the same thing. That Lakitu was fucking on me that time, though. Alright, I need to grab this. I wish there was a way to have that one-up count as, like, multiple feeds or something. I'm just gonna jump out of the way of that one. Thank you for the clip, Smallmouth. Appreciate it. I should probably at some point try to 255. I guess I don't actually know if I set the timer to reset, but... Did I set the timer to reset when you do this? I did, right? Yeah. I'm not gonna do it right now, but I should probably see where a 255 there takes you since it's possible. It's very annoying, for what it's worth, because you have to actually do a jump. Oh! You have to do a jump over that muncher 255 times. It's probably the most engaging 255 ever. Because it's, like, just tedious enough for you to be able to zone out and do, but, like, just hard enough that you actually have to pay attention. Like some fighting convention, I have no clue. So that throw block right there, the reason why I have that entire segment right there is so you can kick it up and steal a Cloud to be able to go to the goal here. And that's it. That's all the flying. I have more Cloud stuff and bunbun 1, so I didn't really want to overdo it here. I think that one, in terms of port volume, was also fine.
Like, half the people in your chat have it!
Huh.
What the fuck? Why don't I have it? Now I'm feeling left out!
This one is pretty noticeably quiet. so good, though. Misleading. I was gonna say a little misleading, and then I was like, no, rope is a lot misleading. No! Oh my god, this last shot's still pretty hard. The first shot seems like I tweaked it during testing enough that it's been consistent so far. Probably now that I said it, I'm gonna miss it. Come on, fireball! I might need to scoot those fish or tile closer. Yeah, good luck. Go take some pretty pictures, please. Should be good with the back one, right? Okay, let's go with those. This is a level that actually slightly changed with its retry spawn, but I actually kind of like it more this way. Because now you have to do a double bounce there. And before you could just bounce straight over, and it actually kind of felt a little more awkward because you were kind of just stuck waiting.
At that point, I think you maybe need to get them a dumpster.
Yep.
And put it in the fucking alley.
Yep.
Why is it taking up an entire parking space?
I don't know.
Surprised. And I'm already mad because I already know I'm gonna have to deal with it in the fucking morning.
I'm just surprised that it's only taking up one, but I'm
optimistic. Well, it's because there's cars already parked.
Oh.
So, like, it's not like blocking a car in, but it is blocking a car from being able to park there when it's an entire spot.
So interestingly, if you move the camera left here at all, this bullet doesn't spawn. So it's actually kind of a fun semi-vanilla don't look left obstacle. Miss Ma'am has decided I am to be her pillow. Good luck being pillow, Momo.
Oh, have a good night, Momo. You have crazy pets. You will, but like for me.
You will. I'm glad I rewound the flashing again. I completely forgot I designed the second half of diagonal holes. Not gonna lie. It's a good thing that level's on the shorter end. It's funny to go from that dramatic ass music just back to the Kingdom Hearts music. Alright. Oh yeah, I need to actually add info boxes here. I've also never played this level with the switches active, so let's see if this is even possible. Let's go! Oh yeah, I completely forgot that these switches means that this first room is moving. The first room's not moving anymore. Okay, so I just need to tweak that from being a setting at all then. Because if it doesn't work after the first time, then let's look on. But now it's back to moving, and now it's stopped moving. So it stops moving when the camera swings? That's fucking weird. I don't think this is possible. It might have actually been, but I think the Reznor platform would have bonked in the background. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna reset this to not move, but then deal with it in there. Whoops. Because it's a little weird that it's now triggering, like, sometimes when I enter this room.
How did I just run off the edge? There's gonna be ads. Sorry, I just actually saw that, so let me run them now. Okay, so I need to add message boxes here, remove the conditional check for if the blue switch is active, since it seems to be inconsistent. Is it like if I've seen the blue switch in the same thing? Nope, it's just inconsistent. Okay. Is it after. Hold on, is it if I touched a blue switch? Because now I'm curious. Okay. I touched that block. From the side and it didn't count? I mean, check this. If I stand on top of a blue switch block, is that what triggers them? I'm curious. No, it just triggers something. Well, if that's the case, then I'm glad that the trigger to stop spinning when you're looking left in room 2 is as consistent as it is. Probably at least have those resonant shield or something. The room feels a little passive once you get to the top. This is also negative 15. This is actually probably played a little slightly. Oh no, this sounds good. I'm unsure of why this platform stayed. Does that actually allow me to live here? Wait, what happened here? I mean, I can design around that. Like, honestly, my exact setup probably works fine, I just have to shift it over. But it is very odd that it... Yeah, if I have the fireballs on the screen, I should definitely have the fireball. Oh, so now it's fine? That's awkward. That's even worse, actually, because now I can't build it consistently. So now it's working as intended. Hmm. The music credits here, by the way, are not complete because I added in a lot of the like post-boss sound effects and stuff since I did this, so I have to go back and add a couple of people to this. Which I think means I'm gonna have to remove the border from something. Which is fine. Figure out either, I guess. Yeah, overall I would say that went pretty well. There's a couple of things I want to take a look at. I also am going to want to let this play through to the end screen and then do a reset to see how many exits bunbun3 actually has. Because I think that last level doesn't technically count as an exit because it's running credits, and I might need to look and see if there's a way to have it count. Because it is like a full level, it feels kind of weird to not have it count as an exit. I might also want to look into if editing the global palette edits this background, because that might be kind of nice. We did at least get this fixed at the tail end of stream last time, because it turns out that if you edit Yoshi's house and replace it with X graphics at all, it like super messes up this ending cutscene. Yeah, I think before this goes out to testers, all I really need to do at this point is do all of the audio leveling that I did tonight. And like actually try to level everything, at least to a port so people can adjust. Take a look at the couple of instances of retry being a little funky. It's mostly the water level, dais lighting, and kind of the end boss. Well, the end boss, because there were a couple of things that I need to look at with the end boss. Because, like, sometimes the blue switch was triggered, quote-unquote, which is why the Reznor in the first room would spin sometimes. It was supposed to be spinning every time if you had the blue switch going, but for some reason the game just, like, didn't keep track of that specific trigger the same way every time. So I think I'm just going to remove the option for it to spin in the first room at all and maybe just add another hit or something. Because at least that way it'll kind of... Because the first room definitely needs some kind of buff. It's significantly easier than the other ones. And then the final Reznor room was fine after it loaded that one like weird offset time. Which, like, even then, I think it was still possible. It's just kind of awkward. I need to see if that happens every time you get to the Reznor for the first time, or if it's just that time. I don't think that I need to view these credits to a specific point. Like, I think basically after you hit credits, it's just as far. Okay, so let's reset and see what the exit count actually is, because I think it might be 24. It is 24. Okay. In that case, let me look into... I think there's credits Uber ASM that has the last level count as... I had this set as negative 25 to negative 20, but I think the beginning's just a little quiet, because looking deeper into this port, it's like pretty solidly at negative 15, so... Okay, so... Looking through, I'm basically already audio leveled. There's a couple of, like, really quiet ports that I need to bring up. And nothing I need to bring down, really, I don't think, except maybe the water level. Okay. So, looking through, I think the rest of my to-do list is gonna potentially be stuff I do offline. Because the only other thing that I think would really be interesting besides the final playtesting edits and stuff, obviously, would be creating a new title animation. But I think after this run, most of the level design felt pretty good. There's a couple of like obstacles here and there I need to tweak up. I'll watch back this VOD and kind of take notes on everything I was saying as I was playing it. But I know there's like an obstacle about every other level or so that I wanted to take a look at. I don't think there's really going to be a whole lot of like complete demolition of segments, which is good. I feel like it's going to be more like tweaking an obstacle or two per level, potentially. But not even that much, honestly. But just in terms of overall changes, I think 0.9 is going to be making to 1.0 at least. Yeah, this is about the time I stream till anyway, so I think we'll go ahead and wrap it up here. We were able to do our first run of bunbun 3, which is pretty cool. I will look into some ASM to potentially have the last level count, because I like it being around 25 exits instead of 20.